recruiting such large program in 15 different countries with a lot of patients that are enrolled in these studies in a placebo-controlled manner, I think was something that shows really the ability of our team and especially of our clinical operations team to execute such difficult, complex study and bring it to the end of recruitment. That's what we are basically have announced today.
All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Dr. Andreas Muehler. He is the Chief Medical Officer for Immunic Therapeutics. And Dr. Muehler, good to see you again. Welcome.
Thank you very much, Steve. Good to be back here with you. That's wonderful.
Yeah, I know you've got a couple of things you want to talk about. First off, you've announced the enrollment for your phase 3 ENSURE trials. So let's take a step back and remind everyone about ENSURE and what these trials are going to do.
ENSURE is our ongoing phase 3 program for relapsing MS, and it consists of two studies that are identical. We call them twin studies for that reason, that and are scheduled to enroll about 1,050 patients per study in patients with relapsing multiple sclerosis. And this is a placebo-controlled program, and we were able to report today that we finished the recruitment of both of these ENSURE trials, ENSURE 1 and ENSURE 2, with full enrollment. I think we're very happy that we get into the next stage, basically, of this phase 3 program, where we follow these patients for the prescribed follow-up period of 72 weeks, and then have the ability to read out these studies next year, at the end of next year, actually. And we had planned this as a placebo-controlled study for many reasons that I can explain, but this is something I think a very strong achievement for the company, because recruiting such large program in 15 different countries with a lot of patients that are enrolled in these studies in a placebo-controlled manner, I think was something that shows really the ability of our team and especially of our clinical operations team to execute such difficult, complex study and bring it to the end of recruitment. That's what we are basically have announced today, which is I think a milestone for our phase 3 program, and also it indicates that the company in Munich had really been able to execute on the program that we had chosen and selected for our phase 3 program in relapsing MS.
Yeah, Dr. Muehler, we're talking about over 2,000 patients, 2,221, 100 sites, 15 countries. I mean, this is a very large one for sure. You mentioned the placebo part of it, and maybe this is a good opportunity to get you to explain why that placebo part is so important.
Yeah, I think we thought that it was very important that we enrolled this as a placebo-controlled study. We have a safety and tolerability profile for vidofludimus calcium that we have seen in other studies in MS, but also in other indications, that was very similar to placebo. Basically, there was no really leading or characteristic side effect profile or a specific leading lab abnormality that we had seen. And it would have been very difficult to do a study with a active comparator that has a leading side effect or that has a characteristic lab abnormality and still maintain blinding, for example. And I also think it's very important to note that regulators have really given every company the choice of using either placebo or an active comparator in the MS field. But they really also consider, of course, placebo a very good comparator in a sense, in a scientific sense, because it allows you to really see the activity of the drug, not compared to the activity of another drug, but in a sense allows a full assessment of efficacy, safety, tolerability against basically a backdrop of not treating these patients. And I think it's, in a scientific sense, it's a very good comparator. Of course, there is a question always about are we able to enroll patients in a trial where, of course, you have to expect that you are randomized in a blinded fashion to a placebo arm for a period of 72 weeks follow-up time here, like in this trial. And this can be addressed with some ethical consideration that we put into our trial, into our program, and that allows these patients to react, for example, if they have certain events in the study, that also limits the exposure in these events and gives them options there. And I think this has all been considered. And so we are really put into place a scientifically very rigid phase three program that also fulfills all of the ethical considerations that you have to have nowadays if you run a large program in relapsing MS.
Okay, so that's the ENSURE trials that we talked about. You also in this news release talked about some secondary endpoint data from the phase two CALIPER trial. So maybe let's get a quick update on what you're seeing there.
Absolutely. I think we're very excited about the recent unblinding and data release for our phase two CALIPER trial in progressive multiple sclerosis. And we had, of course, we are getting more and more of the data and we have them analyzed. And we reported on basically the primary and key secondary endpoints initially, and we have more and more data now coming. And the data that we released today is basically the potential future phase three primary endpoint for a phase three study if you continue in this indication, which is called time to 24 weeks confirmed disability worsening based on a disability score that's called EDSS. Mm-hmm. And what we have seen with these data that, for example, the overall study has a 24% reduction of the risk of having these 24-week confirmed disability effects. It's measured as a hazard ratio, which takes into account not only the event risk but also the timing of these events, and that's a very good and clinically meaningful reduction of confirmed disability worsenings in these treated patients with 45 milligrams of vidofludimus calcium. We have also seen that, for example, in the subpopulation of primary progressive MS patients, there's a 33% reduction of these 24-week confirmed disability hazard ratio. And in non-active SPMS, another very important subpopulation, we see 19% reduction of these hazard ratios for confirmed disability worsening. So I think we're very pleased with this. We've also seen, like in other endpoints, that patients who do not have signs of focal inflammation at baseline actually doing quite well as well in this study. And there's really no difference in terms of the performance of the active treatment in patients overall and patients without the signs of focal inflammation. And it's very important because all of the drugs that are approved for MS in general are anti-inflammatory drugs. So that they work extremely well in patients that have signs of focal inflammation at baseline. And that that's called gadolinium lesions, MRI lesions, gadolinium MRI lesions at baseline. If you take those patients out and only look at patients who don't have these signs of focal inflammation, these anti-inflammatory drugs really haven't done well, or they have a much less of a treatment effect because they're anti-inflammatory drugs. And here what we have seen is that in principle, our treatment effect is independent of these signs of focal inflammation. Really, I think, supports our hypothesis that this drug is very different, that is, could be potentially the first neuroprotective drug because we have two separate mechanisms of actions here, one anti-inflammatory and one neuroprotective drug. And we believe that it really, I think, hints in the direction that we were hoping for, that the effect of this drug in a progressive MS population is driven by the neuroprotective effects of this mechanism of action of this drug.
Absolutely. Lots of important work done and still lots more to do, for sure. Dr. Muehler, thank you so much. Good to catch up with you, and I really appreciate your time.
All right. Thank you, Steve. Good talking to you.
Yeah, good talking to you as well. Dr. Andreas Muehler, the Chief Medical Officer for Immunic Therapeutics.